Buck Henry. Oh, new water today. So today on this live stream, we're going to talk about how to use your social media the right way for maximum profitability. We're going to talk about how to use your social media the right way for maximum profitability. Feeling good out here today, too. Feeling good. We're going to give a chance for some people to hop on.
We got Rocky Moe in the building.
Rocky, what's going on?
Valencia on.
Valencia, what's going on?
Talking about some Western words, sir. Read the caption, V. Reading is fundamental, girl. She talking about somebody see them toes.
Oh, yeah.
Oh no, that was Rocky Moe. That was like, what's the word, sir?
Gotcha.
Okay, okay. Todd, what's going on, Todd?
What's going on, Todd? So today we're gonna talk about how to use social media the right way for maximum profitability. We'll report live from Atlanta, Georgia, at the Rise of the 1% headquarters in Buckhead. Shout out to Antonio on the camera today. How's everybody's Thursday? How's everybody's weekend? I know I'm excited. We ended off the month of July. It's been a great month. August gonna be even better. We're extremely excited.
Todd said all is good.
That's awesome.
Rashina said, hey y'all, what's going on, Rashina?
Woo!
What's going on, V? Yeah, man, people tuning in.
Awesome. I'm gonna lay some great information on this live screen today. And the reason I wanted to talk about this subject, by the way, is for one, these are some of the first steps we take a lot of our clients through when they join like our high-level coaching and training program now, the Rise of the 1%. And a lot of times too, when I look at a lot of different marketers, when I look at their social media pages online, a lot of them are not set up the right way. And I know by the way that their social media pages are set up, they're not really getting the results they want. Most of them. Majority of them. So I want to just go over some fundamentals and some basics. We're going to have fun on this live stream today. I just want to go over some fundamentals and basics to help some of you entrepreneurs out there, some of you business owners out there, some of you all that might be in marketing, share some things with you on how to set your social media up the right way. All right? But before we do that, I'm going to let Antonio give y'all a little bit more of this view real quick. It's beautiful out here at the Rise headquarters. We got some beautiful people out here.
Yep. Yes, sir. Yep. Out here in the Buckhead area. Owena. I hope I pronounced the name right.
Welcome, Owena.
Miss Brown.
Miss Brown, okay, awesome. All right, so when it comes to setting up your social media the right way for maximum profitability, the first thing, and some of this stuff, you all may say, okay, this is very simple, but what I always tell a lot of my students is, don't say that this sounds simple, I heard this before. Say, have I applied this? How often have I applied this? And what are the results I'm getting from it? That's what I always tell all of my students. And Antonio's giving a head nod because he knows that. Because he's a part of the Rise of 1%. He's also a social media director of the Rise of 1%. So with that being said, the first thing in your About Me section of your Facebook page, let's talk about Facebook specifically. Antonio's more of an Instagram guy. I'm going to focus more on Facebook today, being that's my lane. On your Facebook personal and business page. And by the way, if you're marketing online, if you're marketing on Facebook, you need a Facebook business page as well, whether that's branding you or your company. So that's the first thing I want to share with you. In your About Me section, you need to have what you do, okay? Who you're helping and how you're helping. Hope somebody just caught that. In your About Me section of your personal profile page and even your business page, you need to have what you do, who you're helping, and how you're helping them. And if you have a link to some type of lead capture page, I would recommend putting that in the About Me section as well. You do not want to send traffic directly over to a website on social media, because you have no way to generate leads on that website. I'm pretty sure if you have a standard website, you have no way to follow up with the traffic that visits that site. So with that being said, you want to have a link to a lead capture page. If you need assistance with putting lead capture page together, just reach out to myself. In conclusion of this live stream, we can have a discussion about it. But you need a link to a lead capture page, who you're helping and how you're helping them in your About Me section of your Facebook. I look at so many business owners and entrepreneurs and marketers' social media pages online, and when I look at their About Me section, because a lot of times I want to network with a lot of people. And when I go to that page, I don't even know what they do, right? I may have seen them like in a Facebook group posting and stuff like that, but when I go over to their profile, I don't even know what they do. I'm looking at the About Me section. I'm like, what does this person do, right? They just have up there like a lot of women. I'm just gonna keep it real. A lot of women say, you know, single mom, a wife, right? Child of God or whatever. And there's nothing wrong with any of that stuff. But what I'm saying is, if you're gonna be in business, and you're gonna be building a business on social media, you need to have in your About Me section who you're helping, how you're helping them. And if you have a link to some type of opt-in page, a lead capture page, or some type of offer on it, okay, when you can generate leads, I recommend that having that in your About Me section. That's the first thing. Did y'all catch that? Did y'all catch that? Or do I need to throw some more water? I'm going to get Antonio wet. If y'all don't say nothing, I'm going to get Antonio wet. Antonio don't want to get wet.
Hey, I'm a Pisces. I'm a natural born swimmer.
So you all going to talk on this thing. Y'all going to communicate with us. Antonio don't want to get wet. Who want to get wet? Do y'all want to get wet? I'm going to throw some water on y'all.
All right, Carrie just tuned in. Ray still. Naeem just hopped on.
What's going on, Ray? What's going on, Naeem?
Owena said, cool, awesome stuff. Very true.
Done. Thank you, though, but I'm not done. I'm glad you get some value so far.
There's more to it.
Yeah, there's more to it. That's just the beginning. And I want to know who's going to take action on what I share, because we have clients pay us like thousands of dollars for this information. So I want to know who's going to actually take action, get off the live screen, and immediately change the About Me section on their social media page. The next thing you're going to need, you need a clean profile picture. I'm going to write that down. You don't need a picture of your dog. You don't need a picture of your cat, your baby.
Your rabbit. Right?
What'd you say, my man?
I said your rabbit.
Your rabbit.
Your rabbit.
He just told y'all, you do not want a picture of your rabbit.
Especially your pet mouse.
Not a pet mouse either. You can't have a picture of that on your social media.
This wasn't scripted.
Was it? Or you don't want to have a picture of some type of slogan up there. I see that a lot on social media.